Hello, I am Manas Wabuskar of Team Professors, and today I am going to quickly guide you through the Selenium test process. So Selenium is an automated test which is used to for testing certain softwares or in this case web pages. So today we are going to test our landing page. For that purpose, I'll quickly show you how to set up the Selenium. For that purpose, you need an Eclipse. You need to download Eclipse, especially for Java. To download an Eclipse, just we have there is no installation. You have to just open this. Then we have to select the workspace. In my case, it's in Eclipse Selenium, and then just press OK. So it will just open up the workspace. I'll show you the workspace that I've been pushed into the source tree. But I'll show demonstrate how to create all this. So first of all, you have to this page, all page will be blank. So first of all, we have to just make a new project. So for that, you need to right click on this new, then Java project, which will create this Java project. Inside that, you will see source file, JRE system, no reference libraries. So inside this as this is a Selenium project, so we need to import the Selenium packages, or we can say drivers. For that purpose, you have to now right click on this patent and go new and then folder. So after continue doing this, we need to rename the folder as lib, that is libraries, inside which we have these drivers and stuffs. So as you can see, I have three drivers. First is Selenium drivers. How I created this is that I clicked on libraries and right click new and then a new folder, and inside that I created and named this folder as Selenium jars. And inside this Selenium jar, we have copy pasted this Selenium standalone. Now we'll get the Selenium standalone in after going to after you Google search Selenium HQ, go into the Selenium website, go to download, and from here you can download the latest version which is available. So you'll get, after downloading this, you will get the Selenium jar. I have downloaded already and I have imported it, so I'm not showing you. As you can see, you can download this way, and then we have used the Chrome browser for testing it. So we have used this Chrome driver. Also, we have created this folder using the same library. We're right clicking library, selecting the folder, and then creating this and copy pasting this Chrome driver. So I'll tell you where you will get the Chrome driver. The same download page, we have to go down, and as the Selenium supports mostly Mozilla, Firefox. Chrome is a third party for them, so you can download third party Chrome driver from here. Click on this and you will get the latest one. So just click on this and the download will start. So coming back to the Eclipse, after you copy paste it, also you can get the Geeko driver. Now Geeko driver is the Mozilla Firefox driver, means it just simply launches the Mozilla Firefox browser instead of Chrome. Here we are using Chrome, so I have used Chrome driver as a main driver. So you can just okay. After doing that, after we have imported it, we have to load this Selenium driver in order to use in this script. So for loading that, just click on this, right click and build path, and then you have to configure build path. So after configuring the build path, the Selenium standalone will go to the reference libraries, as you can see here. So that's done. After that, we have to create this code, this Java code. In order to do that, just click on the wait one second, just click on the source. After clicking on source, we have to create a package. So after clicking on source, go to new and create package. After creating a package, you will get kind of this. I have named it as patent test. After patent test, we have this Java files. But to create a Java file, you need to right click this, go to new and class, that will create a new Java file in like this. So in this project, there are already these files will be there if you are using this particular one. But if you don't have this, if you have these files but you don't have kind of these packages and all, just don't plainly copy all of these into this package, because this because in case you create a new patent name, it will not detect it all, or it is they have don't have the same properties kinda, so it will give you an error. The best part is just create a new Java file inside this package and then copy all the contents from import till the till below, so you can just get means you'll get an error free code. After you get that, after you download all these, copy all this code, you will find some errors here. You will find mostly 3-4 errors. I'll just show you. Mostly will be the import one. If you see, if you use the Eclipse, then you will just find it easy to import all these, because for example, I'll show you one thing. If you use thread.slip, if you get an error that you means you haven't thrown an interval expansion, then exception, then you just right go here and then it will just do that thing. After that, you will get an error saying that send keys do not pass a string. So for that purpose, you have to just right click on, if you want to go, remove that error, just right click on this, go to build path, then configure build path, and then go to Java compiler, and it initially this would be checked marked and this would be 1.4, you have to click it to 1.7, then apply, then okay. So I have already done it, so this thing will be gone, the error will be gone. Also you will find some errors here, this buy one, buy dot export. Now buy dot export, we have to import a package. So hovering on this, you can get the hovering on this and just going here, we'll get the this package which will be imported right here. So these are the common things which you'll get after just copying the paste, copying the code. So just remove it, as I've said. So enough of this thing. Now just go for the main thing, that is testing all this. So basically all this code is quite long. I'll just fast forward it to you. First we'll test the landing page. So just to run as Java application. As you see, just right click on this and just select run as application, and the search will start. I'll just keep this cursor over here so you can see that it's an automated testing. I'll just fast forward these things because it's quite long. So here you go. So as you can see, the test has been completed successfully. As you can see, there are no errors here. And now let's move on to the patent search test. That's, as you can see, the same way, right click, run as the application. Okay, so is that opened up? I'll just keep the cursor over here. Patent search. Then Professor Sasta, this patent version machine USPO version 2 over here. Then Professor Sasta, this surname, last name, as you can see here, this patent. Now we'll go to the view document. You see the view document thing, and then everybody just close it out. As you can see, there are no errors, so this code is running error free. And next is the success stories. We'll just run it again. Again the same thing, keeping the cursor above. Patents licensing, success stories. Typing the success as patent Ranu. You see Dr. Ranu came up and submit stories. That's the thing. Let's close this out. As you can see, no errors. Then we'll move to the business search. Right click, run Java application. As you can see, once again, it goes up. Patents licensing and search business search, hotels, Mumbai, but there are no hotels in Mumbai with the help of Yelp, so it will cancel out. San Francisco, yeah, everything going good, test is going good, no errors. Then we'll click on one, save select. You can see all is selected, remove, done. So as I have, as you can see, we have successfully conducted this test. Now what if you want to show that that test is not going through? So for that thing, for that to achieve, we need to make the code, so make some errors in the code. For that purpose, I'll just make some errors. Okay, so we have made some errors in the code. Just go to VIP, tool shape, delete data, VIP, refresh the page, patents and licensing. Yeah, we are done. Now we'll just start testing it again. Now we have created an error in the business search test. We just right click, run as, and see, we'll see this works or not. As you can see, it's running successfully, initial test, but the error is if we click the business and search tab, then it will not go ahead. So you can see it click the business search tab, but it never went ahead. As you can see, if it was expected that it will open up the search which will search for hotels and in Mumbai, San Francisco, but it doesn't. So this search has stopped, means there is an error somewhere. And if you want to see the error, you can see it in the console. Scrolling up, as you can see here, that there is an error which says no search element, unable to locate element method selector text term. Now we have to see whether what is this method ID selector vector text term. As you can see here, you can see it here, the ID is text term and send keys hotels. Now I'll explain you what this error means. See, basically it clicks on the business search tab, but it cannot find the term called ID text term because there is an error in this search as we have created here. There is an error, so it cannot locate, and that's why this search stops and gives an error. So as in this way, we have seen the use implementation of Selenium, also the user guide in how to install how to install basically Selenium using Eclipse, and write and the code, and also the basic setup. So here was the user guide of my user story. So thank you for watching this video, and here is my details. Thank you.